Hi, Cinema Movies here. Today, I'm going to explain a science fiction action film called The Discovery. Spoilers ahead. Watch out and take care. At the beginning of the movie, we see Professor Thomas Harbour being interviewed. He has recently proven the existence of life after death. The interviewer claims that his discovery was dangerous, because ever since his work was published, the suicide rate has been skyrocketing. He dismisses the claim by saying that such a crucial truth about human life had to be brought to people, regardless the consequences. Thomas has been able to capture brain wavelengths on a subatomic level, leaving a person's body when they die. This explains that a person's consciousness goes somewhere when they die. But the interviewer insists that since they do not know where consciousness goes, they cannot tell for sure if the afterlife exists. Thomas tackles the claim, saying that when a train leaves the station, we know it is going somewhere. She then brings up that many celebrities, athletes, and hundreds of civilians have ended their lives because of the professor, and asks him if he feels responsible for their deaths. Thomas simply answers that he doesn't. Just then, one of the camera crew stands before Thomas and thanks him for a fresh start. He shoots himself dead right after. In a similar fashion, people have been committing mass suicide to restart a new life in the afterlife. It is now the second anniversary of the discovery. Thomas's son, Will Harbour, is traveling on a ferry, listening to a TV program talking about his father's discovery. As it turns out, the suicide rate has not decreased ever since. Will turns the TV off, making it clear that he is not proud of his father's work. A girl from the other seat startles him. They are the only ones on the ferry. She introduces herself as Isla, and Will comments that her face looks very familiar. The two chit-chat for a while. The conversation turns to them talking about the discovery. Isla is a supporter of it, but Will exclaims that he doesn't believe in it. Isla claims that the discovery gives people a way to get relief from the sufferings of life, but Will stays adamant about his view. After they get off the ferry, Isla hitchhikes in a car, leaving Will at the harbor. His brother Toby comes to pick him up. The two drive to a huge mansion bought by their father. Thomas has built his new station in the mansion and has employed people who survived attempted suicides. Will is confused to see labs and machinery inside the house. Thomas has been conducting some kind of experiment. Will meets his father and bluntly asks him to stop all this. He wants Thomas to tell the media that his discovery was false and stop the chain of mass suicides. Thomas laughs at his idea and claims that his discovery was 100% true, and he won't lie to anyone. As it turns out, Will was the inspiration for the discovery. When Will was young, he had an accident and died for a minute. When he was resuscitated, he had told his parents that he saw flashes and a little boy in front of him. This provided Thomas with the idea that life after death might exist. Hence, Will blames himself for the deaths and wants his father to stop. After the conversation, Will goes outside to cool his mind. But just then, he sees Isla on the beach nearby. She seems to be packing her bags with weights. Isla wears the heavy bag and goes into the sea. Will realizes she is about to commit suicide and runs to save her. He goes into the water and manages to save her, but Isla is furious. He takes her to the mansion and asks Toby to take her in, since they help people who are suicidal. Toby agrees, but she will have to go through the questionnaire first. Isla is surprised to discover Thomas is Will's father. Thomas then conducts an interview with Isla, asking her questions about her life. Meanwhile, Will goes around the house and sees that it has been fully converted into an establishment with canteens and rooms for every patient. At night, everyone gathers in a room while Thomas presents something to them. He brings out a man with a device attached to his head and claims that he has figured out a way to see the afterlife. Till now, the world only knew that our brain waves leave for somewhere after we die. But now he has figured out a way to see where the brain wavelengths go. Will and the others are shocked. Thomas explains that with the device, they can see a video recording of the afterlife. Later, everyone is at Thomas's office. He wants to be the first one to be experimented upon. But he has to be dead for that. Heads, they decide to perform it on an already dead person, which they have to steal from the morgue. On their way there, Toby reveals to Isla that their mother committed suicide and Will blames his father for it. At the morgue, Toby distracts the keeper, letting Will and Isla to successfully steal a corpse of a man named Phillips. That night, Will and Isla sleep on a bunk bed together. Will tells her that his mother killed herself on the day of his parents' wedding anniversary. His father was never attentive, and she was left hopeless when Thomas didn't come out of his office on their anniversary. Will had found her dead body in the bathtub the following morning. The two talk for a while and sleep, while holding hands. The next day, everyone is ready to perform the experiment. They attach the corpse's head to the device and hit a button. While Thomas waits for something to show on the monitor, nothing happens. They do it repeatedly, but to no avail. A disappointed Thomas leaves the room, and everyone else follows. However, when Will is alone inside, the monitor starts working and shows a clip of Phillips meeting a woman at a hospital. Will quickly turns it off before Thomas comes in again. They have to let Phillips's body go for cremation and Thomas asks Toby for a new corpse. Will and Isla take the corpse back to the morgue and leave it on the ground outside. All of a sudden, Isla kisses Will. The two are awkward later and do not talk on the ride home. Will cannot get the thought of the video out of his head. He has downloaded it to his laptop. After some research on the internet, he finds the hospital in the video. Will dives to the hospital and walks through the passage Phillips had walked. However, he reaches a dead end that was not in the video. A janitor informs him that there used to be a passage before the hospital was renovated a decade ago. Will realizes that the video could not have been from the future. He predicts it to be Phillips's memories displaying on the monitor. His father had made a memory device rather than something that shows the afterlife. Later, everyone gathers at the mansion for a session, when Thomas calls a patient named Lacey to the stage. Lacey has been speaking against the discovery and Thomas's new invention, claiming that it will cause more mass suicides. Thomas confronts her in front of everyone. As it turns out, he had found Lacey in the woods ready to kill herself and had saved her. In the end, he asks her to pack her bag and leave the establishment. Will is furious at Thomas for embarrassing Lacey, but Thomas dismisses the matter. Later, Will shows Isla Phillips' video. The two go to the same hospital to investigate Phillips' case. Together, they find Phillips' father's file with his address on it. They believe that in the video, Phillips was visiting his father on his deathbed and the woman he met was probably a relative. Later that night, Will has a chat with Toby who tells him that Thomas has been working on this machine for their mother. Thomas is guilt-ridden because of his wife's death and wants to know she went to a better place. The following day, Will and Isla go to the beach, where Isla tells him that her 5-year-old son had died by drowning at a beach because she fell asleep. That was the reason she wanted to die before Will saved her. The two then go to Phillips's house and meet his sister, who happens to be the woman from the video. She informs them that Phillips never came to meet her father at the hospital. None of his family likes him, as he had been awful to them. Will has noticed a tattoo of a lighthouse on Phillips's arm in the video, but the woman tells him that he had a wave tattoo instead. Will realizes the video is not Phillips's memory, but rather his afterlife. Phillips has gone back in time to correct his mistakes in life after his death. As it turns out, in the afterlife, people relive an alternate version of their life and get a second chance to make different choices. Will and Isla are surprised by the discovery. They are in their room when suddenly, Toby barges in and calls them to see Thomas. Thomas has attached himself to the device to try to figure out the machine. He has suffocated himself and is on the verge of death. The monitor starts working again. This time, it shows Thomas on the night of his wife's death. It was their anniversary. He had not come out of his office that day, but in the video, he tells his wife that work can wait and has dinner with her. He had been given a chance to correct his mistake, and he did.